everyone. My name's Natasha, otherwise known as Cannon Doll X, and I'm the host of a show called Talking Toys, where I let you know what hot new collectibles you can find at your local comic shop. Today I'm here to answer some questions from the Batman statue collector, and here we go. Are you ready? I am. Maybe. Let's see. Number one, how did you first get involved in the geek culture world? Well, that's a really loaded question considering I've been a comic book fan since I was about 6, 7 years old. I couldn't really read the comics just yet, but I loved the pictures, I loved getting into it, and as I got older, comic books became my outlet, my safe place. I was bullied in school and picked on a lot because I was not afraid to be a dork or a geek or show the fact that I loved Star Wars or horror movies or anything like that. So X-Men was my outlet, Batman became my hero, and that's how it really all started of me getting in the geek culture. Two, are you involved in the indie comic book scene? Actually, I am. I'm a host of a show called Indie Edge. It is a monthly segment that is now going to be evolved into a new show. I can't say because spoilers, but it gives a chance to spotlight the indie creator, the artists, small press titles, just anything that, you know, is not your mainstream comic book. And it's pretty great because, like, I feel, you know, you've got to find your passion. And at my job of being a host and being able to spotlight these artists, it gives them a chance to be seen. And these books should be read because, you know, they're great books and great stories. And some of them are heartfelt. They're not always superhero stories. And I think, you know, the world should get to know that. Okay, number three, do you collect anything or want to collect anything in the future? I do collect pop, not like avidly. I'm a little picky about it, only because I don't have a lot of space at our house, and honestly, like, I have a five-year-old and she'll steal most of them. But I did used to collect Spawn collector, McFarlane toys, figures. I actually used to I used to get up at like 2 o'clock in the morning on Thursday nights, and I'm from California originally, and I would go to the 24-hour Kmart, and about 2:30 is when they would pull out inventory and start stocking the shelves, and it was my chance to get my hands on all things Spawn, because I love Spawn. Todd McFarlane is one of my favorites. I love Venom, but I used to avidly collect the Spawn figurines, and I lost them all in a depressing story that I'm not going to share now, but I collected those, and eventually, it's taken a long time, but I think I am ready to start collecting those again and get my hands on them. It'll be trickier to find, I think, now, some of the originals, but no, I love toys. I love collecting. It's really fun when you have certain aspects, like I'm a big Wonder Woman fan. I love Assassin's Creed, Batman. I mean, I could go on and on. The fandom is endless. Star Wars, I mean, we have, like, a lot of things around my house that are actual, like, working toys like BB-8, and I have like the little watch and you can control them and all that kind of stuff. So yeah, I like to collect things, and I guess in the future would be more Spawn stuff. Let's see, who's better, Batman or Superman, Marvel or DC? Really, this is a question you're gonna ask me? So a little history, I've got Batman here. I love the Dark Knight, the Batman is my dude, but then I also have Superman hidden back here. There's a long story behind this particular tattoo, but then I also, on this side, I have the Punisher, I have Rogue, and I have X-Men. So I've got, and I've also got Star Wars here. So this is Marvel, Star Wars. I did not know the merger was going to happen ever, but maybe my arm predicted it. And then this side has Star Trek and DC. So I'm not a separate kind of fan. I'm all about inclusion. I love my superheroes, whether they're on the Marvel side or the DC side. So I can't really say who's better. I have a soft spot for Superman and his journey, but then I swear anytime it doesn't matter whether it's animated or live action, the moment I see Bruce Wayne lose his parents, I cry. Like every time, I can't help it. It's just such a sad story, and he turns into like a great hero. But let's see. Number five, how did you get involved with doing the YouTube videos? Actually, I came in to Sapphire Studios, which is where I'm recording now, and came in for a production meeting. I had a bunch of show ideas and things like that, and they liked them, they went for them, and then the next week I found out, oh, well, we're going to have you be on camera, we're going to do this show and this, and I was like, wait a minute, I thought I was going to be behind the camera, not in front of the camera. Well, a year later, I am still doing this in front of the camera. I still do some behind the camera work, but predominantly in front. And who knew I would like this so much? I like being able to bring like great toys and collectibles to the masses, as well as spotlighting those indie comic creators. So that's pretty cool, and it's really fun. And I get to geek out professionally, so that's always a joy. Let's see, tell us about Toy Chest News. Toy Chest News is a great channel on YouTube, and it doesn't just have my show, Talking Toys. We also do 360 unboxing, where you get to see really close up some of the statues and collectibles that are hitting store shelves, and gives you a little bit about it, where to find it, how to find your local comic shop. So it's a really great channel. It's youtube.com/toychestnews. They're also on Facebook and Twitter and Instagram, of all the social media places, and it's all one word, Toy Chest News. Tell us something cool about yourself that you want us to know. Besides being a geek, I also am an athlete. I've been playing roller derby in January. It will be 14 years. I'm one of the handful of human beings that has been doing it this long, and I absolutely love it. I'm captain of a team called the Dundalk Deviants here in Baltimore for Charm City Roller Derby, and we just won our championship game this past Sunday, which would have been October 13th, just in case of whenever this is going to air. And we are undefeated. We had an undefeated season, and it's probably been a decade since I've been part of a team that had an undefeated streak. So that was really exciting, especially because it's only my second year skating with Charm City, and a great group of human beings and just really strong athletes. We compete competitively across the world. So that's really exciting also to be a part of. Where can you find me on social media? Well, it's really easy. Cannon Doll X, which is my derby name. And it's also my gamer name. It's my Twitch tag, my Instagram, my Twitter. Pretty much, if you just Google Cannon like the weapon, Doll like Barbie, and X like X-Men, smoosh it all together, and you have Cannon Doll X, which is me. And you can find me on all the social media platforms. I also have a YouTube channel called youtube.com/CannonDollX, and that's where you can find me. Thanks for sticking around and watching this. And one last note, I want to thank the Batman statue collector, and he'll see you at the Batcave.